Hey, what's going on, guys? Josiah Novak, and today we're talking about how to stay motivated to lose weight. Talk to guys all the time about the mental game, and I want to give you my five best mental tips to implement when it comes to getting ripped, getting lean, and losing weight, because the mental game doesn't get talked about enough. So we're going to cover it today in today's video. If you want the five best secrets to staying motivated while you're losing weight, keep watching and let's jump into today's video. All right, guys, so motivation is a very misunderstood topic. And I know we all want to be motivated all the time. We want to wake up ready to attack our goals, ready to get after it, ready to make progress every single day. And when you're doing something like losing weight, not every day is going to feel like your best day. You're not going to wake up every single morning motivated to attack your goals. In fact, I would even argue that most days you may not feel like doing the work that needs to be done. I know that there are many, many days in my life where I wake up very unmotivated. In fact, I don't want to do what I need to do. I would much rather lay around, watch Netflix, eat what I want, relax, and not get anything done. So how do you fix that? How do you get over that mental hurdle that is lack of motivation? Well, first of all, we have to start by understanding what is motivation. The best way I can describe motivation is this. Motivation is simply an emotional state. It's an emotion. It's like anger or excitement or adrenaline rush or happiness, like over the top happiness, right? Where it's something that doesn't last forever. You know, if you're frustrated, at some point you're gonna get over that frustration. You're gonna get back to baseline, if you will. It's kind of like motivation. Sometimes you're going to feel extremely motivated. You might see a picture that gets you motivated. You might watch a video or a movie, or you'll hear something. Or sometimes you look in the mirror and go, whoa, I don't like what I see. I need to get my butt in gear. I know a common way that people get motivated is they set a deadline or they have an event coming up where they want to look and feel their best. Especially when it comes to weight loss, having something to shoot for, a target, can be very motivating for some people. But understanding that motivation is simply an emotional state will help you realize that you're not always going to be motivated. Just like I hope you're not always angry or overjoyed all the time, because that would be weird. You wouldn't even appreciate these individual emotions when they do happen if you were that way all the time. So tip number one is understand that motivation comes and goes. We have to learn to accept this and also expect it. I wake up and I have this funny quote that I put on social media all the time. It is, I didn't feel like working out today, so I went and worked out today. This has to be the mentality. I don't feel like doing this, so I'm going to do this. Understand that's how motivation works. It's not always gonna be there. So that's tip number one. Tip number two is understanding that when you don't go after your goals and you don't level up, you don't lose weight, you know, stop worrying about impressing other people. Stop worrying about letting other people down. Understand you are letting yourself down more than anything else. You are developing a pattern of low self-belief, low self-esteem. You're setting yourself up for failure by not doing what you need to do. If you want to get quickly energized and motivated, then think about the person you care about in your life the most. How would you want that person to be? Would you want that person to be lazy, tired all the time, feeling like crap, run down, overweight, insecure, scared to take their shirt off, uncomfortable at the pool or beach or lake or whatever? Of course not. You'd want that person to feel great. You'd want that person to wake up every single day, ready to go after their goals, ready to crush it and do what needs to be done. Well, guess what? That person, yes, whoever you thought of as extremely important in your life, I'm sure it's someone that you held near and dear to your heart. But guess what? That person really should be you. Because if you're not showing up at your best, if you're not crushing it in your different arenas that you're in your life, well, ultimately you can't go out and serve at your top capacity. You can't go out and show up for that person you love so much as your best self, if you're not showing yourself that same love and care that you'd want for that person. So I think about this when I'm lacking motivation. I realize that more than anything, I'm just letting myself down. I'm selling myself short. So what I would suggest is, and this is tip number two, I would suggest waking up every day and realizing that you need to fill up your tank and your cup if you want to go out and serve others. That is an utmost important task in your day. All right, so let's jump into my number one hack to get quickly off the couch, up and at it, and tackle whatever you're not feeling motivated to do. I call it the 10-minute rule. I've talked about this on a video. I covered this whole thing, and I'll put the link right up here so you can go check it out. We go in depth on what the 10-minute rule is, but it is a hack that has literally gone viral online and inside of our coaching group. And what does the 10-minute rule do? Well, simpler, I'll put it to you like this. The 10-minute rule is literally 10 minutes. That's what we're gonna utilize to get motivated. We're gonna utilize a small chunk of time to do whatever it is that you don't feel like doing instead of thinking about the whole big picture, the whole pie that you're trying to accomplish. Let's give working out as an example. You have an hour workout plan for your day. You wake up, you're not motivated. Well, do you sit there and go, man, I really don't wanna go work out for an hour? No, of course not, because the more you think about that hour, the more it's gonna seem daunting and just impossible, because you don't have the energy, you don't have the motivation. So here's what the 10-minute rule does. You just commit to doing 10 minutes of that thing. 10 minutes, that's it. Anybody can do basically anything for 10 minutes. So you go work out for 10 minutes. You commit to that small chunk of time. And then after 10 minutes is done, you check in with yourself. If you feel like continuing on and finishing the workout, then keep going, go crush the whole thing. If you don't, if you're like, man, I feel even worse, I'm not ready for this workout, I can't do it. Well, the good news is you have my permission to stop, go home, recharge, and come back the next day. Why? Because you committed to 10 minutes, you did it. You knocked out the commitment that you had made with yourself. That leads to more self-belief, which leads to more motivation because you understand you can do this. You're more than capable, all right? But here's what's gonna happen 99% of the time. I can guarantee it. You'll do 10 minutes and go, that wasn't too bad. I can totally do the whole thing, or at least more than 10 minutes. It might be 20 minutes, 30, or maybe it is the whole workout. Here's the cool part. You can apply this to every part of weight loss, whether it's meal prep, whether it's choosing a healthy meal over something not so healthy, whether it's ordering the right things on the menu when you're out and avoiding the appetizers and the junk food. You can apply the 10-minute rule to everything, because all you gotta do is the right stuff for 10 minutes. That's it. And then that's gonna lead to you doing the whole thing. I guarantee it. 99% of the time, you will knock out what you need to do. It's a little hack to get you mentally in the game. Okay, I have another hack for you. We're gonna rush through this one, but this is called the bedtime rule. This is the first time I've ever talked about this. I've learned this from other mentors, but it's something that I think about. When I'm in the course of my day and I'm doing what I'm doing to lose weight, eating right, working out, moving more, all that stuff we've talked about. If I run into a situation where I don't feel like doing what I need to do, here's what I think about. I think about when I lay my head down tonight and it's bedtime and I think about my day, how am I going to feel? If I look back and say, man, I didn't do what I needed to do, man, I'm regretful. I feel like a loser. I feel like a failure. I'm letting myself down. And in turn, I'm letting the people I care about down. Man, that really sucks. I don't like going to bed with that feeling. And I definitely don't like waking up with the feeling of like, yesterday really was a bad day. I didn't do what I needed to do. Man, I let myself down. I suck. I don't want that feeling. What I want is a feeling of accomplishment. Like, yes, today was a great day. Yes, yesterday was killer. I'm ready to keep this going. Momentum is headed in the right direction. I love this. That's the feeling I crave. So when I'm in the moments during the day where I'd rather slip up because it's more comfortable, it's easier, I pause and say, what am I gonna think tonight when I lay my head down? It's the bedtime rule. I highly suggest you use it. Okay, so this is my last tip of the day here when we're talking about how to stay motivated to lose weight. I want you to remember that action always comes before motivation. So if we're sitting around waiting to get motivated, waiting for lightning to strike out of the sky and us to all of a sudden feel like Superman and want to go out and crush all our goals, and we're sitting there with our head in our hands on the couch, butt in the seat going, man, I can't wait for motivation to knock on my door and get me fired up. Well, guess what? It's never going to happen. It's never gonna happen. In fact, you're only gonna feel less motivated. Why? because you're not taking any action. Action leads to small results, small wins, things that you can go, ooh, that felt good, like a workout. You walk out of the gym never regretting that workout. You feel better, your energy's higher. You feel excited about the opportunities that you have that day. That leads to self-belief. So action, results, self-belief. That self-belief is that voice in your head that says, I can do this. I got this. I'm capable. And then momentum starts to happen. Momentum of things moving in the right direction. And that, my friends, is when you get motivated. I can't tell you how many times this has happened to me in my life, in many parts of my life, whether it's relationships, money, business, friends, family, and obviously fitness, where I needed to just simply take an action. That action led to a small win, which led to results and feeling better, self-belief, momentum headed in the right direction. And then I would go, man, I feel so motivated to keep going. That's how you get motivated and stay motivated to lose weight or do anything in your life that you want to accomplish. All right, guys, that wraps up today's YouTube video. Hopefully it helped. Please leave me a comment below letting me know which one of these tips was the best one, which one you found the most valuable. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and subscribe to the channel. We're dropping two videos a week, Wednesday and Friday, all geared around using fitness to transform not just your body and your physique, but your entire life. If you're a guy over the age of 30 who wants to lose weight, who's sick and tired of letting their busy schedule, excuses, family, or whatever it is get in the way of taking care of yourself, well, my Lean Body Formula coaching program is where you want to be. Check out the link in the description of the video if you're interested to learn more, or if you're just starting out and you want to explore what we have to offer. We have a free Look Good Naked guide that you can download. It's always in the first comment if you want to check that out. In the meantime, I'm Josiah Novak with thetruetransformation.com. I will talk to you on the next one. Remember, life moves fast. Make it count. Peace.